Welcome to North East Web Shorts. You are watching Daily Evening News Bulletin with me, Sushila Chetri, starting off with the national news. India's COVID-19 vaccination coverage crosses 77 crore landmark milestone. More than 57,11,000 vaccine doses were administered yesterday. Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman will chair the 45th meeting of the Goods and Services Tax GST Council in Lucknow on 17 September. Finance Minister from all states will attend the meeting. CPI leader, former JNU students, Union President Kanhaiya Kumar meets Rahul Gandhi likely to join Congress. The Congress had been in political wilderness in Bihar for the past 3 decades. The Congress could win only 19 of the 70 seats it contested. National Aerospace Laboratories, a part of the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, has adopted the Dassault Systems solution to design civil aircraft in the country. The passenger experience industry solution experience helps in reducing engineering cost in cabin. The Union Minister of State in the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, Rajiv Chandrasekhar, inaugurates 5 National Institute of Electronics and Information Technology centers in Northeast region at Tuibong, Aizwal, Tejpur, Kokrajhar and Kohima. The Indian Space Research Organization is conducting studies and mini projects to enable the vertical landing of its rockets. ISRO is aiming to recover the first 2 rocket stages of the GSLV Mk3, as this would imply a huge cost advantage and savings owing to reusability. Andhra Pradesh, the AP government has constituted a jumbo 81-member board for the Tirumala Tirupati Devasthanam's nominating 52 special invitees on an unprecedented scale, along with 24 regular and 4 ex-officio members besides the chairman. On August 8, the government appointed Chief Minister Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy's uncle Y.B. Subba Reddy as TTD chairman for a second consecutive term. Tirupati attracts over 36 million worshippers annually, and the TTD would vastly benefit with the addition of eminent personalities as special invitees. Bihar, 2 boys fined over Rs 900 crore credited into their bank accounts in Katihar, Bihar. 2 boys have accounts in Uttar Bihar Grameen Bank. They were expecting to get some money under a government scheme to buy school uniform and pay for related expenses. Local report says the bank is investigating the transactions. Delhi, in a massive scam case, the Central Bureau of Investigation has booked a Delhi-based private firm, Indian Technomath, for allegedly defrauding 16 banks of funds to the tune of Rs 1,528 crore. Gujarat, the new Council of Ministers of CM Bhupendra Patel was sworn in on 16 September. Governor Acharya Devrat administered the oath of office and secrecy to the new ministers at Raj Bhavan in Gandhinagar. Total 24 ministers, including 10 cabinet and 14 ministers of state, took oath. 2 women members were also included. Jammu and Kashmir, Union Minister Narayan Rane lays foundation stone for development park at Bari Brahmana, Samba district in Jammu and Kashmir. He also said steps to be taken for upliftment of these ventures and generating employment opportunities for local youths. He urged the employed youth of Jammu and Kashmir to take full benefits of various centrally sponsored schemes for employment generation. Karnataka will join a number of states to oppose a proposal of bringing petrol and diesel into the ambit of the goods and services tax, as there are concerns such a change may lead to lower revenue. The GST Council is scheduled to meet in Lucknow on 17 September. Maharashtra. The Bombay High Court on Thursday dismissed a petition filed by IPS officer Parambir Singh seeking to squash inquiries initiated against him by the Maharashtra government, and said he can approach the Central Administrative Tribunal. He was shunted out as Mumbai Police Commissioner in March 2021 in the aftermath of the Antilia bomb scare case. Telangana on 16 September unveiled its information technology policy for next 5 years. State Information Technology and Industries Minister K. Taraka Rama Rao formally launched the second IT policy in Hyderabad with focus on digital empowerment of citizens' innovation. The Supreme Court Thursday granted last chance to Telangana authorities to permit immersion of Lord Ganesh idols made up of plaster of Paris in Hussein Sagar Lake in Hyderabad. The Telangana High Court on September 13 had refused to modify its earlier order banning immersion of Ganesh idols made of plaster of Paris in Hussein Sagar Lake. Telangana Cabinet approves quota for BCS, SCs, STs For setting up liquor shops, 15% reservation will be extended to the BCS, Gowda communities, 10% reservations to SCs and 5% reservations to STs from the new excise year beginning 1st November. Telangana Saidabad rape accused found dead on railway tracks near Jangaon. The accused Palakonda Raju, age 30, was identified by the tattoo marks on his arms. He was accused in the case of rape and murder of a 6-year-old girl. Last week, Telangana cops had announced a reward of Rs 10 lakh for information on his whereabouts. Uttar Pradesh, the construction work of the first phase of Sri Ram Temple in Ayodhya was completed on 16 September. General Secretary of Sri Ram Janmabhoomi Tirath Kshetra Trust Champat Rai told. Aam Aadmi Party Uttarakhand Chief SS Kaler resigned from the post on Tuesday ahead of the assembly polls scheduled next year, soon after the party announced 3 working state chiefs. Announcing his resignation, Kaler said that the party has asked him to contest the upcoming election against Chief Minister Pushkar Singh Dhami in Khatima. Khatima is the hometown of Kaler and he has claimed that he has already started poll preparations with door-to-door contact programs. West Bengal, the West Bengal CM on 16 September was interacting with the non-Bengali community of Babainpur, which makes up 40% of the area's population. She said, Bengal will protect Hindustan and will not allow it to become Pakistan or Taliban, as this was the land of Rabindranath and Nazrul, so we all will stay together. Chief of Defence Staff General Bipin Rawat said that there can be more turmoil in Afghanistan. A weaker adversary like Pakistan will always try to engage India. He added that Pakistan is a proxy of China, which is India's adversary on the northern border. A combined team of 200 Army and Air Force personnel are in Russia to participate in Exercise Peaceful Mission being held between the member states of the Shanghai Cooperation Organization from September 13 to 25, that also includes Pakistan and China. The Indian Air Force will hold an air shower over Dal Lake in Srinagar on September 26 that will help motivate the youth of Jammu and Kashmir to join the IAF. According to officials, more than 3,000 school children and college students will attend the show. Ministry of Defence has constituted a high-level expert committee for a comprehensive review of National Cadet Corps. The committee's effort will be to make NCC more relevant in changed times. Cricket icon Mahendra Singh Dhoni and industrialist Anand Mahindra were on Thursday named in a 15-member panel constituted by the Defence Ministry to carry out a comprehensive review of the National Cadet Corps in order to make it more relevant. The 8th edition of the Indian Army Chiefs Conclave, a gathering of serving and former chiefs of Army staff of the Indian Army, organized at New Delhi from September 16 to 18. The highlight of the 3-day event will be the invite extended to former chiefs of the Nepali Army who were also chiefs of the Indian Army. Moving on to international news. PM Modi will virtually address the 21st meeting of SCO Council of Heads of State today. The meeting is hosted by Tajikistan capital Dushanbe, where India will be represented by External Affairs Minister Dr. S. J. Shankar. Indo-US cooperation will go a long way in restoring normalcy and boosting the economy in the post-pandemic world. Defence Minister Rajnath Singh has said, inviting technology collaboration and transfer through joint ventures with Indian companies. PM Modi discusses comprehensive strategic partnership with Australian PM Scott Morrison. On 15 September, PM Modi held a virtual discussion with Australian PM Scott Morrison where both leaders discussed India-Australia comprehensive strategic partnership rapid progress, including the recent 2+2 dialogue which took place in New Delhi. India and Australia held a 2+2 ministerial dialogue to improve ties and the Indo-Pacific region's defence and security systems. PM Modi is slated to attend the Quadrilateral Framework Leaders Summit in Washington on September 24 alongside Australian Prime Scott Morrison, Japanese Prime Minister Yoshihide Suga and US President Joe Biden. The leaders are expected to discuss regional problems of common interest during the meeting as well as the progress made since their first virtual summit on March 12. The 15th East Asia Summit Energy Ministers meeting was held on 16 September virtually. Minister of State for Power Krishan Pal Gurjar attended the meeting along with other senior officials of the ministry from the Indian side. The theme of the meeting, We Care, We Prepare, We Prosper, aimed at coordinating efforts of Asian countries in pursuing the goal of energy security and energy transition that will benefit the people of the region. Moving further to world news. Today's star of the latest Google Doodle, Michio Tsujimura, born on 17 September 1888, Saitama, Japan, was a Japanese agricultural scientist and biochemist whose research focused on the components of green tea. She was the first woman in Japan to receive a doctoral degree in agriculture. US, UK and Australia have announced the formation of AUKUS, a new trilateral security partnership for Indo-Pacific region. It was announced in a joint address by British Prime Minister Boris Johnson, his Australian counterpart Scott Morrison and US President Joe Biden with a vision for a safer and more secure Indo-Pacific. The Quad leaders PM Modi, Japanese PM Yoshihide Suga, Australian PM Scott Morrison and US President Joe Biden will meet at the White House on the 25th of this month. Both Quad and now AUKUS are more than likely to be seen as counterweights to China's growing muscle flexing in the Indo-Pacific region. French President Emmanuel Macron has said that French military forces have killed the head of Islamic State in the Greater Sahara, Adnan Abu Walid al-Sharawi. Three Bangladeshi films have been selected for the 26th Busan International Film Festival to be held at Hyundai Busan in South Korea from 6 to 15th October. Rehana Maryam Noor, directed by Abdullah Muhammad Saad, No Landsman, directed by Mostafa Sarwar Farooqi and Pyar Tule Matinai, No Ground Beneath the Feet by Rabi Mirdha have been included in the section named A Window on Asian Cinema of the festival. South Korea has successfully completed an underwater test launch of an indigenous submarine-launched ballistic missile on 15 September. Pakistan PM Imran Khan has said the US war against terrorism was disastrous for Pakistan as Washington used Islamabad like a hired gun during their 20-year presence in Afghanistan. This comes 2 days after US Secretary of State Antony Blinken on 13 September said the US would reassess its ties with Pakistan following the military drawdown from Afghanistan. Moving on to sports news. Indian cricket team captain Virat Kohli on 16 September announced he will step down as India's T20 skipper after the T20 World Cup in UAE but will continue to lead the side in ODIs and Test cricket, a decision that paves the way for Rohit Sharma to captain in the shortest format. India's ODI tour of New Zealand postponed to 2022. India will not be touring New Zealand later in the year due to a packed calendar and COVID-19 related restrictions. A New Zealand cricket spokesperson confirmed to Stuff that the India games will be played after the T20 World Cup in Australia next year. New Zealand will be hosting Bangladesh, the Netherlands and South Africa in the summer besides the 7 teams in the Women's World Cup in March to April. Coming towards the end, let's look at the COVID update national. India recorded 34,403 fresh coronavirus cases in the last 24 hours, 12.5% higher than yesterday. Union Health Ministry bulletin showed the active cases account for 1.02% of the overall cases in the country. 3,33,47,325 recorded since the beginning of the pandemic. So this is it for today. For more updates, keep watching Northeast Web Shows. Thank you.